Undefeated IBF welterweight champion Errol Spence Jr. defends his title Saturday, March 16th against fellow unbeaten Mikey Garcia live on Fox Sports pay-per-view from AT&T Stadiums in Arlington, Texas. The champ is joining me now. Errol, how excited are you to perform this weekend in your hometown?
I'm very excited. This is a dream come true, and just to be fighting in front of my fans and, you know, my loved ones and family members, it means a lot. You know, it's something I dreamed about for a long time. And now it's time to make this moment the best moment of my life and get this victory in spectacular fashion.
Now, on paper, this is the hardest fight of your career with everything at stake. How do you plan on not letting the pressure and the moment get into your head?
With me, you know, pressure is a mental thing, and you know, a lot of times people try to add more pressure on you than you got on yourself. So, you know, I don't have any pressure on myself. I'm 100% focused. Training camp went great. I'm in shape. I got tunnel vision on Mikey Garcia, and I'm not worried about any pressure at all. I just got to perform that I know the way I can perform, and it'll be a great night.
Now, many people have predicted that your size is going to be too much for Garcia this weekend. You've been the underdog before. What's it like being such a heavy favorite, and how do you keep that edge as the champ?
I keep that edge as a champ because I always have that underdog mentality. You know, I'm always, you know, the one. I'm always the hunter, not the hunted. So I never, you know, even see myself, you know, as a champ. I always see myself as somebody that's always trying to prove something. So that's how I always keep that competitive edge and keep that competitive nature about myself.
When you talk about that underdog mentality, you've been in Garcia's position before. You shocked the world defeating Kell Brook in his hometown for the IBF belt. This time, Garcia's hoping to do the same to you. What gives you the confidence that you're going to stop him from taking your title in Texas?
What gives me confidence is because I know, you know, this is not only a size advantage. I have the skills, I have the talent, and I have the smarts to beat Mikey Garcia. So, I mean, I feel like I have the all-around know-how just to beat him in the skill set and the talent. So, you know, whatever he brings to the table, I feel like my camp and I, we didn't work around it, and we have a game plan for anything he can bring.
You called Mikey and his camp out for talking trash leading up to the fight. We don't usually see that side of you very much. Do you think that this feud has gotten a little bit more personal?
I mean, every fight is personal. I mean, I'm fighting, you know, for my livelihood. I'm fighting for my reputation, fighting for my belt, you know, my name, you know, basically, you know, my livelihood. So, nah, I take every fight personal. But, you know, this fight means a lot more to me, just fighting at home and my first pay-per-view on Fox. So, you know, I'm a little more pumped up than usual.
Did he get under your skin a little bit more than fighters normally do?
He not really got under my skin. I just, you know, don't really take well to arrogant people. So, I mean, that's probably got under my skin a little bit.
Well, I know you promised to punish him this weekend. What kind of message do you hope to send to the rest of the division on Saturday?
Send a message that I've been sending, that, you know, I am the 147 kingpin. I am, you know, that guy in the weight class, and, you know, I'm the guy that's going to take over the throne that, you know, Floyd Mayweather left behind. So, you know, I'm going to send that message come Saturday night to all the people at 147 or everybody who's thinking about moving up or coming down to 147.
Keith Thurman has called you the second best welterweight in the world. Do you feel as though your peers are still underestimating you?
Nah. I mean, Keith Thurman, he's a jokester like that. You know, he hasn't even been active enough to even say who's the best, you know, welterweight in the division. He's been gone. So, I mean, I don't see him as the best. I see myself, maybe Terrence Crawford, then Sean Porter, and then Keith Thurman. He got to get more active to say that, you know, he's the first or the second best welterweight in the division. He was just in a life and death fight where it was supposed to be a tune-up fight. So, I mean, he got to get his stuff together before he even mentioned my name or anybody else's name in that top three.
Any chance that you might be fighting any of those guys coming up?
Well, if you listen to Keith Thurman, we won't fight till 2020. So, I mean, that fight is not going to happen. So hopefully I'll fight Manny Pacquiao or Sean Porter.
All right, we'll be waiting to see that. Let's shift gears a little bit. You're fighting at AT&T Stadium, so I have to ask about your Cowboys. How happy are you to know that Odell Beckham Jr. is out of the division?
Oh, I'm happy. I mean, I wasn't really too worried about Odell Beckham because, I mean, the Giants are not that good anyway. So, I was just worried about what we do in free agency and, you know, hopefully, you know, we'll pick up another wide receiver because we got rid of Cole Beasley. And, you know, do something in free agency. So, you know, that's what I'm more excited about.
Well, and you have Jason Witten returning from retirement. Do you think this team is prepped for a Super Bowl appearance?
I think so. I think, you know, we're missing a little bit of missing pieces, but we're definitely going to get there. With Jason Witten coming back, you know, I think he took a year off just to recover, you know, body getting banged up for all those years. And, then he's gonna come back with fresh legs and a somewhat fresh body, so that's gonna be good for Dak Prescott.
Yeah, certainly a lot to watch there in Dallas, and a lot to watch this weekend as well. Errol, we wish you the best of luck in your fight. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.
You can catch Errol Spence Jr. defending his IBF title Saturday, March 16th against Mikey Garcia. It's live on Fox Sports pay-per-view from AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas.